The results are in. You guys have voiced your opinions. If you are one that did not see this post and you are opposed to this, then feel free to go to my community tab and vote. But as it stands, we have a new intro, boys. So yeah, again, without further ado, let's get into the video. Hello, my beautiful little Mugglets. What's going on? Oh my god, I regret doing this. Today, the final week of the Sides of Story is here. I wanted to check out hard mode of tournament. We checked out normal mode. I'm giving my sort of thoughts on the rewards. I have not even looked at it yet. But as you can see, we completely cleared normal mode just because we've been farming these tokens in preparation. I'm interested to see the costs and everything. So let's go ahead and start with like the tier 4 rewards here. Got a penguin artifact thing. So these are actually pretty similar to the normal mode rewards, if not exactly the same. Yep. I think they're actually the same. Oh, but we got a Mulligore seed on both sides this time. So yeah, definitely want to grab both those Mulligores. And of course we have Soul here. But okay, let's just go ahead and start with one. I'm gonna go, yeah, I don't necessarily care about these two bottom rewards here. Definitely more about the Mulligores. So we're gonna be fighting Purgus and Kitty Clarissa. And who we start with doesn't really matter. Probably the best of these four is the artifact thing. Those are kind of hard to get, and there are so many artifacts I have to raise. So let's start with Purgus here. They are level 35, which means we're going to keep our completely ungeared Kisa in there. She needs to be raised anyway. And seeing as they're level 35, it's probably not going to be very difficult. Yeah, Baikin's second skill, which is basically just a warm-up for the ultimate, killed one of them already, so hopefully Soul will be at least a little bit of a challenge. We'll see, though. I didn't check actually his level. I would assume he's gonna be 60, but maybe not. Yeah, it was too much for you, buddy, but maybe next time. Yeah, he's 60, so we'll see. We're actually gonna go with my arena team for him. Yeah, actually, General Purgus is our only other option here, so let's go ahead. Also, the cost... 300? What was this one? 100? Or 50? What? Why is it still 50? They said hard mode's gonna be more expensive. I can't check. I'm pretty sure those were already 300 as well, and then 1,000, then 2,000. So it's kind of weird. Maybe they decided to not increase it, because even normal mode was quite expensive already. Don't worry, we will be we will see about this. Well, Baikin's second skill couldn't actually kill them this time, so I think we might be in danger. Nope. Moving on to the level 50 Baikin. Again, we're gonna go... Well, I mean, we're gonna use all of our tokens, which I think we have more than enough to do everything anyway. So, yeah... As far as I know, there's not going to be another tournament using those tokens, so if you have any left over, you know, I'm not sure if we're actually getting experience for this. Maybe you should take Kisa out. We'll keep her in there for now, and then... Oh no, our Kisa might die. Oh no, don't do it. Our Baikin has died, though. And our Kisa, we might lose this one. No, I think we're probably fine. Yeah, bye. I love those Mulligore seeds. Alright, moving on to Soul. Let's take our usual arena team, I suppose. Actually, I don't think we can really one-shot anything because Dizzy's in there and she's gonna be, like, doing some stuff. I'm sure Fortune but, today as well. Yeah. Let's just see. Maybe it's actually hard. Maybe it's not. Trying to be ready for it. Here we go. Oh yeah, I forgot this dude. It always startles me when like I'm fighting a Soul in arena and I do Judith's thing and he starts like moving and I'm like, what the hell's going on? And then I'm like, oh yeah, it's Soul. So doing Dizzy's ult, I can usually gauge how strong they are based on, they're actually pretty strong, damn. Like even in normal arena battles, I'm doing more damage than that. This might actually be kind of tough. Here we have our Watcher Shuri. I'm actually not sure if I should try and get rid of the Ruella, whatever she's called, so she doesn't revive? Or, like, maybe C-Dom back there? Let's end this. Probably, oh no, but she's just gonna get revived now. I think they could do it. And I don't think Shermia without a burn is gonna be able to get rid of Ruella. Usually I burn Shermia's thing, but doesn't really work with Dizzy in there because she needs those 20 souls. And even though I have maxed out the book, it's just still not enough, unfortunately. Try and get rid of those attack buffs, maybe? Nice. Get rid of you. Yeah, so it wasn't too hard, I guess. Like, they didn't get much of a chance to attack, and then, like, you know, with Dizzy in there, they're just kind of debilitated anyway. And I guess that'll do it. So, perhaps for more mid-game players, it's gonna be a pretty cool challenge. I would say maybe very hard. I can't really gauge how hard it was because, again, they didn't really have much of a chance to do anything, which can kind of go to show something. But I guess we're going to start over here on Cid. Like I said, we're probably going to do like all of them, but yeah. Oh lord, Dizzy's ult. And yeah, the other Molagora seed. Let's go for it, I guess. So I mean, all in all, like, it's basically normal mode, just harder. I guess that makes sense. What else was I expecting? I mean, we can have two Molagora seeds now instead of one. Also, we might be able to max out our soul, actually. Now, free 6-star. I'll take it. Yeah, alright, guess I'll come back later and finish that up. Not really anything super exciting left to grab there. But, like I said, we might have all the souls we need. Let's go check that out real quick. No, we're missing one. Did we not grab our reputation reward? Or something? Ah yes, we actually did not. Oh wait, but that's just the gold transmit stone. Do we have to use a 5-star dog thing? Or is he in here? No? Yeah, see, it looks like we are missing one. It only goes up to SS? Well, I'm probably missing something obvious. Somewhere. Oh! Yeah, here it is. Resolution Fortress. Oh, there's a whole new thing. I wasn't aware of that. I thought it's really just the tournament this time. All right, cool. Well, we're good. Oh, that worry for nothing. What currency do we get here? Hopefully not the tournament currency. Oh no. Oh no, it is. Okay, well, we only have to do every place like once, I guess. So it's cool. Also, I get the feeling no one cared about me narrating the week 2 side story, so I kind of skipped week 3, and I'm not gonna do it this time either. It was actually a lot of effort for like no reason. And yeah, I know, while it was just like reading the dialogue or whatever, it actually did quite take a long time to edit. So I guess I'll do that later. I guess I can take this time to give my final thoughts on the side story for anyone that cares. I thought it was really nice. I thought the story so far, we have, I think, a little bit more to go, has been good. I'm not really familiar at all with Guilty Gear, so that is that. So if you are, that would probably enhance the story bit to bit. Rewards have been fine. I think Soul is a pretty interesting character. I'm sure we're going to be seeing a lot more of him in Arena starting like today, because now we can have him free 6-star, free triple S memory imprint. What actually is his memory imprint? He isn't a natural 5-star, so it can't be anything flat, right? I know I probably should know these things already. Okay, defense percent isn't really very exciting, but still. Free, almost 13% defense memory imprint. Might be pretty nice for a wall comp, honestly. He looks like a bruiser, and he is a warrior, which are kind of like the bruiser types. And defense, of course, helps teams like that. So, you know, like the Kins, the Askarts. My main problem is that he also has no AoE, and that's really what I'm lacking right now. So I don't know if I'm actually gonna, like, you know, get his skills up, get him gear right now. Seems quite solid, especially for a free character though, so pretty, pretty nice. My Shuri is no better than he was before, but we are in the process of raising some stuff. We have a couple of interesting crit damage necklaces, like this one. I thought was quite good. It's on the effectiveness set, which is unfortunate. I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do with him right now. I could do like effectiveness and like two crit chance sets, which would be really weird, and he won't be able to be at like super high speed, but then we can give him like speed boots. I don't know how I'm going to get all that crit chance. I only have a couple of units that can get away with not having crit chance necklaces. Bikin is not one of them. Shermia is, but then she only has 85%. She does have Hellcutter, and she is like the slowest most of the time, so she'll, I think, have 100% by the time it's her turn. And then we have Luna, obviously. She doesn't need a crit chance necklace. She's actually 4 crit chance less than she should be to be at 100% as long as she's above 50% HP. So that I've been wanting to fix, but it's like, you know, all that stuff's kind of weird. It wouldn't take much. It's like I need 4 crit chance, and it's hard to find just 4 crit chance. As a matter of fact, I think probably Shuri has a sword with 4 crit chance. In fact, he does. Might think about switching that. And yeah, like, no one has 100%. Says, I think he also has a crit chance necklace. You've got to get really lucky with substats to hit 100% crit chance without a crit chance necklace. But yeah, all right, enough rambling, I suppose. I asked you guys yesterday if you have any newish game suggestions. So I'll probably be checking some of those out tomorrow. And yeah, we'll go from there. But that'll do it for today. Make sure to tell me what you think in the comments down below about what. Actually, we kind of just looked at the tournament and then talked about a few random things. But hey, that's kind of what we're doing all the time anyway, isn't it? Regardless, if you do have any thoughts, you can drop them down there. Leaving a like if you happen to enjoy is always greatly appreciated as well. Thanks, as always, for watching, and until next time.